If someone has money, if they have power, they can pretend to be as pious as hell, and no one will ever suspect how evil they are. I learnt that firsthand working as a vice detective in Sydney. You know how many female half-Aborigine detectives there were before me? None. Yeah, you think it was easy. Suffering the abuse of my so-called colleagues. Half of them hated me because I was a girl, and the other half didn't like the fact that my mum was a Koori. But when it's the end of the bloody world, no one gives a shit who you are or how big your bank account is. I saw it in the resort as the infection spread, and the rich, they died just as quick as the poor. And in Moresby, where the powers that be blew the bridges and trapped the less fortunate in the worst of it. But in the end, it didn't save any of them. When all the lies are stripped away, and the only thing between them and the bloody end is me, suddenly Perna is their best friend. Well, bugger them. I'm not here for them. I'm here for the ones who can't protect themselves. Anyone who lives in fear, I will protect them. And I will die for them. Because I was one of them. My name's Perna, and I'm gonna tell you about the worst bloody holiday ever. I was at the Royal Palms Resort on Benoi, working as a bodyguard for some asshole CEO. I figured once he left the island, I'd have a good week to relax on the beach, enjoy a Mai Tai or two. But no, that wasn't to be. As I woke up one morning to discover that the goddamn zombie apocalypse had arrived. A local lifeguard by the name of Cinnamore saved my life. Soon after that, I discovered I was immune to whatever this plague was. I met a few others who were immune, and somehow we were all elected to save everybody else. There was Sam B, a one-hit wonder hip-hop star from the States. Logan, an ex-football player and full-time douchebag who never missed a chance to hit on me. And Shin Mei, a sweet little hotel clerk who was as brutal with a blade as anyone I had ever seen. Together, we went to Moresby to try to gather more supplies. And from there, things really went to hell. The army tried to contain the infection, but they were bloody useless. Benoi itself was totally isolated. It was pretty clear we were on our own. At this point, we just wanted off that goddamn island. And that's what led us to that maximum security prison. You see, some dickhead colonel by the name of Ryder White lied to get us to track down what he thought was a cure for this zombie plague. Well, that cure ended up turning White into a giant bloody maniac. Luckily, we hooked up with a prisoner who flew us out of there on the colonel's helicopter. We were off that goddamn island at last. And everyone we tried to save back on Benoi, well, they just didn't make it. Except for that little native girl, Yarima. We spotted that naval vessel just in time, as we were just about out of petrol. We couldn't believe how lucky we were to finally find a safe haven. Get your hands off me!
What the hell?
What is going on here?
Get off me!
Get it off me! Get it off!
Ah!
What's with the cuffs?
Sorry, but I can't take any chances. My orders are to take you into custody and transport you to a secure quarantine area.
And who the hell are you?
Lieutenant Colonel Samuel Hardy. Don't resist and you'll be fine. We just need to be sure you don't pose
a threat.
Man,
we no threat. The threat's on Benoit. You have any idea what's happening back there?
We have an idea. We're hoping you can help us fill in the details. Especially her.
You keep the hell away from her.
Frank Serpo. I should have guessed. Are you the one in charge of this clusterfuck? Watch yourself with this guy. This freak would sell out his own mother. If he had one.
Take the immune down to the lab. The two others will come with me.
Lab?
Do we look like goddamn guinea pigs to you?
I'm a citizen of the USA, man! I got motherfucking rights!
Back off, Serpo. And just stay out of it.
What the fuck, man?
Don't do that again. One less immune won't make any difference. Now take him to the lab.
You may have command over Pelinai, but on this ship, I'm in charge and I have my orders.
Your orders are to follow my orders, Colonel. Would you like me to call your superiors?
Somebody tell me what the fuck is going on here.
They have a very high tolerance, Mr. Serpo. I've already administered 3 doses.
So how much longer? You said we'd have results by now.
Sir, this is uncharted territory. We'll need another day at least.
Just be careful. We don't want them dying on us.
What about the native woman, Yerima?
That's a more complicated case. She's being taken to another location.
Don't worry. I'm keeping a close eye.
God. My head.
What the hell happened? Motherfuckers drugged us.
Who are you?
Hey, we're talking to you.
I'm nobody, really.
You've been bitten. How long has it been?
Long enough. I guess it doesn't affect me.
So you immune too?
So it seems.
What? They plant you here to spy on us?
Right. That's one beat to shit like this. It's all part of my cover.
So they tested you too?
Yeah. I'm guessing they're trying to figure out why we're all immune to this.
How'd you get here?
I was a soldier before the shit hit the fan. Part of a huge humanitarian search and rescue operation. And then that civilian arrived.
Serpo.
Right. Suddenly, the military was no longer in charge, and the rescue operation was called off.
So what are they up to?
All I know is there's a naval blockade around the entire archipelago. No one's allowed in or out. Whatever the fuck is going on, there's nothing to do with humanitarian efforts. That's pretty clear.
Christ, I'm still woozy from these bloody drugs. Where'd the others get to? Did they take him while I was out? This is another fine mess you've gotten yourself into, Perna.
This is Colonel Hardy. The ship's been compromised. If you're down in the hold, I'm opening all the cell doors.
Need to find a way out of this mess. Where the hell is everyone?
Huh.
get my hands on a bloody weapon of some kind. Bastard thinks he's gonna live through this. They're already here. I'm getting sick of this shit. Here.
Damn you! Just get the rock! Looks like the hospital's been breached!
This ship isn't taking me down. Piece of shit is sinking. Water's coming in from everywhere. Teaches me for expecting blue skies and calm seas. This tub's going to sink if it's not brought back under control. Let's go!
can't just leave them here. They're civilians.
If I were you, I'd worry about your own survival, Colonel.
Serpo! You! Get up here! Captain! Come in!
Your captain is dead, soldier. Bloody hell! Is that a rock?
To the bridge!
Yeah, we got another problem!
We've got company! Shoot that bloody thing!
Hey, hey, wake up. You all right?
What happened?
Get up.
The ship.
The ship's dead in the water. Can you walk?
Maybe. Where am I?
But it's really not safe here on the beach. There's an infection, some sort of plague.
Again? Are you fucking kidding me?
The whole island's gone to hell.
Christ, I can't bloody win.
We'll talk later. Right now, you need to move. Head for the Paradise Survival Camp. Look for the big treehouse. You'll find other survivors there. Take this. In the meantime, I'll see if anyone else washed up on the beach. The storm was a disaster.
Thank you.
Jesus, what a mess.
My name is Angela Guerra. My husband Paul and I are Peace Corps volunteers. We've been in Palani, working in a small village in the Eastern Highlands that had no electricity or phones. It has been an amazing time, and they taught us so much more than what we taught them. But after 2 years, we'll soon be on our way home. Unfortunately, a strange illness has swept through the village, and that may delay our departure. The symptoms come on suddenly, and the sufferer is stricken almost immediately. That's why I'm recording this, to document what is happening here. My husband has been down with whatever this illness is since last night. He's dizzy.
Worth anything in here?
Feverish. I'm really starting to worry. Paul? Are you all right? Why are you looking at me like that?
Thank God you're with us.
That was close. I'm glad you made it.
You don't look too good. You should eat something.
I'm stuck here because of that damn monsoon.
Thank you.
rest of the world is gone.
I just want to go home to Halai.
Oh, thanks heaps. Those monsters nearly got me. Oh, thank God. We beat them back. Oh, Jesus. I thought we were goners. Where the hell did you come from?
We were on a ship and it capsized, so now it looks like we're fucked, same as you. But maybe if we keep those things from using the bridge, we can unfuck ourselves.
You're not telling me anything I don't know. The bridge is our bloody weak spot. We've got some fences. Maybe securing the other entrances will slow them down. But I need you to put them up. Can you lend a hand?
Sure.
I appreciate it. Grab the rolled fences and put them up in the designated spots.